Welcome, everybody. Thank you for joining me tonight. My name is Michelle Lorenz, and I'm so blessed and honored to be here with you tonight to talk to you about a topic that's really near and dear to my heart. We're going to talk tonight about nutrigenomics and how you can activate your body's own biology and ultimately activate your own brain. And this topic's really actually super important to me. I am not a mom, but I ended up being a foster mom for the first time at about 5 years ago. And I honestly had very little experience with neurodegenerative disorders other than what I had studied in my psych classes in undergrad. But the child that I adopted ultimately was fostered had tons of problems. He had been honestly traumatically abused emotionally, physically, sexually, in the kind of horrific stories you only hear about on the cover pages of newspapers. And my experience through that whole process was incredibly heart-wrenching, incredibly heartwarming. But I have to tell you, having a child that had trauma, that had in utero drug and alcohol exposure, who had trauma obviously after he was born, left him with just a ton of different issues. There were times that this little six-year-old boy was suicidal, tried to kill me, tried to stab himself and kill himself, ran out in front of cars. He would have rages that would last for hours on end, try to run his head into glass walls, into glass coffee tables, horrific drawings that would bring me to tears. And I would go to bed at night, every night, just praying that I would come up with some answers that I could help this little child. And he was initially, the very first day that they took custody with DCS, they took custody, took him to a counselor, and they put him on some meds, not knowing any of his history. So they diagnosed him with ADHD because they had to give him a diagnosis so that they could get paid. I kept saying to them from the minute that I got him, he doesn't have ADHD. I personally have ADD. I'm pretty well aware of the disease and its symptoms, and he absolutely doesn't have it, but they wouldn't listen to me. And then they ultimately ended up putting him on a medicine for blood pressure. And that medicine, I kept saying, he's African American. You can't put a little child on blood pressure medicine. It's never been tested in kids. And on top of it, he may need that blood pressure medicine when he's older. And then they put him on a medicine for schizophrenics, for psychoses. And I kept saying, he's not having any psychoses. This isn't tested in children. What are you doing? And I eventually went on a mission because I couldn't get anybody else to get me any help to find out what was going on with him, and found that I thought he had sensory processing disorder, ultimately worked with some trauma-informed specialist and got him diagnosed. And that for me was my education about kids that have neurodegenerative disorders and disorders, kids that are on the spectrum. So with his diagnosis of sensory processing disorder, it was an aha moment for me. And I was just, like I said, crying myself to sleep night after night, trying to figure out, okay, now I know what he has. Now what can I do to help him? And so part of what we're talking about tonight is so near and dear to my heart because I wish I had had some of these answers when I was a foster mom. So whether you're a mom, dad, grandparents, or foster parents, or adoptive parents, hopefully this information tonight will give you a little bit of background. So a little bit of background on myself, and then we'll get started. My background's actually in the law, and I managed litigation for crane and rigging companies for about 20 years, and I loved what I did. And so when people approached me about these products and this opportunity, I put my lawyer's hat on, and I approached this like I would if we were gonna be trying a case. I evaluated the evidence. I listened to the witnesses. I looked for clinical studies, and you'll hear about that tonight and why that evidence was so powerful to me. So let me minimize myself here and we will get started on the presentation. So tonight we're going to talk about a couple of different things. We're going to start by talking about how you can actually change your body's genetics with this field called nutrigenomics. We're going to talk about two of our flagship products, NRF1 and NRF2 activators. We'll spend a little bit of time talking about clinical studies in the NRF2 and NRF1 science area. Then we're going to focus on what a lot of you came to hear about tonight, ADHD and autism, and some of the clinical studies that are related to that, new science that's coming out in both of those fields. Then we're going to talk about a few other nutrigenomic products that may help in addition to NRF1 and NRF2 activation. We'll finish talking about some testimonials that will bring tears to your eyes, honestly, and we'll hear from a few experts as well. So as we get started, what is epigenetics? It's really just this nature and nurture argument. It's how our environment impacts the way our genes express themselves. And what we now know is that our genes, they're just blueprints, and only about 20% of them are hardwired. we know now that there's about 4 million genes in our body that we can impact how they express themselves. So when it's a gene that gives us good stuff and we want to turn it on to do more, that's called upregulating. And when it's a gene that produces harmful things and we want to dim that light switch or turn it down, that's called downregulating. And we are going to show you how you can upregulate and downregulate those genes with this science called nutrigenomics. So nutrigenomics, pretty simple. It's just the scientific study of how food and food compounds, how they interact with your genes deep down at the cellular level. And what we know is, I want you to think back for 100 years or 1,000 years or even 10,000 years about what our bodies were exposed to and how that differs from now. So what we know is our bodies, they've been hijacked. They've been overtaken by pesticides, herbicides, insecticides, fungicides, smoking, drugs, alcohol. You can have trauma like my foster son. We know there's toxins, GMOs, our genetically modified food sources, pollutions, plastics, right? You can have excessive minerals, excessive heavy metals like lead for those kids up in Flint, Michigan, or other exposure. Maybe you have lead paint on some of the houses or buildings that you've lived in, and ultimately radiation and all of these things, including some of the good pharmaceutical drugs, they ultimately create harm to our body. They hijack our body. And so what we want to do here with LifeVantage is we want to halt or slow some of that cellular damage. We want to teach you how to biohack your body. And when you biohack your body with nutrigenomics, we're going to help you optimize your own body's genetic potential. We want to help you maximize your performance and that of your children. We want to help you optimize your health. And then really importantly, extend your quantity of life, extend your lifespan, but most importantly, optimize the quality of life that you and your kids have. And all of that we do here with nutrigenomics. So tonight we're going to talk about these five main products. What you see here in the middle are flagship products, our NRF1 and NRF2 activators. And then the product right above them is a NRF2 activated energy drink. We're going to talk about these as we go through the presentation. So as we get started, this is going to be kind of a continuing theme you'll hear about tonight, how aging and neurological diseases, how those are impacted by immune dysfunction, by toxins. So we're going to talk about how you can detoxify your body, about inflammation, especially neuroinflammation in our brain, oxidative stress that impacts so many different disease processes in aging, and ultimately mitochondrial dysfunction. And this is a new developing area of science, only a couple of years old, that people have been talking about it. So as we start about talking about oxidative stress, what is it? Most people have heard the term, but they may not know what it is. So oxidative stress is actually the waste product when our bodies use oxygen. So all mammals use oxygen. We are all going to have forms of oxidative stress. You see on the apple an example on the left, the brown side is oxidation. The green side is without oxidative stress or oxidation. Rust on a car is a form of oxidation. The Statue of Liberty turned from copper to light green patina. That's a form of oxidation. When people age, get wrinkled, age spots, lose the collagen in their skin, those are all forms of oxidative stress. So what is oxidative stress? Really simple. It's just an imbalance between our antioxidants in our body and the free radicals. So we've all heard of antioxidants like vitamin C and vitamin E. Well, we're going to teach you about some new ones tonight that you may not have been exposed to before. So a lot of people go, well, what's a free radical? So a free radical is basically a molecule. So we all know we have molecules in our body. And you might remember from a chemistry or biology class that you need to have an equal number of electrons on that molecule so that it's balanced. Well, free radical is just a molecule that doesn't have an equal or balanced number of electrons. You can see that here on the screen. It's missing this electron right here. And what happens with an antioxidant is they have extra electrons. And so the antioxidant gives that free radical an electron and it stabilizes. Now, before it has that electron, it bounces around inside the cell and it creates damage and destruction and havoc and ultimately death to a lot of things in the cell if we don't take care of it at the cellular level. That's why we want to stop it here before it damages tissues, organs, organ systems, and ultimately our entire body, right? Now, what we know is there's this term called inflammaging, and what that means is our oxidative stress and inflammation gets worse as we age. So you can see as we're young children, almost nobody has to take supplements and vitamins and medicine the minute they're born. Why? Because our body has its own pharmacy. And this pharmacy has a whole bunch of things that are regulated by what are called survival genes. So 100, 1,000, and 10,000 years ago, we didn't have a Costco or a Walgreens pharmacy to go into to get antibiotics and over-the-counter cough medicine. Our body had to have a way to take care of itself. And one of those things it produced was internal or endogenous antioxidants, so way more powerful than vitamin C and vitamin E and the antioxidants that you take. What we also know is when we're babies, we haven't been hijacked yet. Our bodies typically haven't had a whole lot of free radical exposure unless we got it in utero, like my foster son did from his mother's in utero drug and alcohol exposure, right? And so what we also know is as we age, we get more hijacking, more oxidative stress. The more we age, it's this vicious cycle where we get more oxidative stress, and that's because we get exposed to more free radicals. And unfortunately, as we age, our body's internal pharmacy, it doesn't work as well. And that's what's called inflammaging. And that's what you get inflammation in your brain. Now, inflammation can happen in a year or it can happen in 50 years. Inflammation is just the process of continually exposing your body to more free radical load than your body's own pharmacy can help offset, right? So how do we take care of that? How do we mitigate some of that? That's with our flagship product. It's called Protandem. It's a NRF2 or NRF2 activator. And it's sometimes called a NRF2, sometimes called a transcription factor. What that means is it goes down to our genes and it talks to our genes and then says, hey, we need you to turn on those genes. We need to turn on the antioxidants and anti-inflammatories and the detoxifying enzymes. We need you to help boost mitochondrial production. And that's what Protandem does. So first of all, we know it helps regulate 500 survival genes, because 100 or 1,000 years ago, if we didn't have those genes, we would have died off. Our body needed to help keep itself healthy. Protandem also is going to help you slow that aging process, and it's doing that by increasing your body's own pharmacy, by boosting its antioxidant production, and as a result, decreasing your oxidative stress. It's going to help repair and rejuvenate your own cells. You're going to hear about an antioxidant called SOD, superoxide dismutase, that neutralizes one molecule of SOD will neutralize a million molecules of free radicals. So that's how powerful it is. Then you're going to hear about a couple of clinical studies. And this for me was the evidence that I was looking for. So again, I put on my lawyer's hat and I went looking for clinical studies, because when we put expert witnesses on the stand, we ask them, have you authored any clinical studies? Were those studies reviewed by other peers? We have a peer-reviewed clinical study that proves that Protandem, our NRF2 activator, decreases oxidative stress by 40% in 30 days. And if you stay on it for 120 days, you may see a decrease up to 70%. That's why we're seeing the powerful changes that we're seeing so far. And our product also was studied by the U.S. government, by the National Institute of Aging, which is a subdivision of the National Institute of Health. And in that study, they studied Protandem for several years, and they found that it's the only all-natural herbal supplement proven to extend life in male mice by 7%. Now, how does it do that? It does that with all of these five all-natural herbal ingredients, starting on the left, turmeric, which has curcumin in it. A lot of you may have heard of that. Ashwagandha, bacoba, milk thistle, which is phenomenal for our livers and detoxification, and green tea extract, another NRF2 activator. Now, for anybody that's interested, if you are if you're competing in pro sports, or maybe you have somebody who's a NCAA athlete, you should know that our product is BSCG certified, which means you can use it because it's been certified by the Banned Substances Control Group. Now, a lot of people say to me when I talk to them, well, Michelle, I take good care of myself. I exercise regularly. I eat healthy foods. Maybe I eat all organics. I take antioxidant supplements like vitamin C and E. And I actually take turmeric or I take bromelain. They're great anti-inflammatories. Why do I need to take Protandem NRF2? There's several reasons. First of all, this is a study that we did in 2009, our original study about decreasing oxidative stress by 40% in 30 days. That was published in 2006. And then in 2009, we had another study that was funded by a grant from the American Diabetes Association and the Juvenile Diabetes Research Foundation. So a pretty big deal, right? And in this study, they studied Protandem and its synergistic effect. So synergy is basically the way a recipe is combined. And so you can see here, the results of this study, ashwagandha, bacoba, green tea, milk thistle, and curcumin, they were all studied to see if they would decrease the body's oxidative stress. And in comparison with Protandem, they did not. We even studied sulforaphane, which comes from broccoli, which is another wonderful NRF2 activator. What they found is that Protandem was 18 times more powerful than the sum of the parts. And this is really important. A lot of people say, well, what's synergy? Think about a cake recipe, right? You combine flour and sugar and butter and eggs and vanilla and maybe some milk. And how you combine those creates what's called a synergistic effect. So you could have a great cake that Betty Crocker wants to make, or you could have a cake that nobody wants to eat. That's synergy, and that's the same impact of our patented NRF2 activator called Protandim. So that's the first reason. The second reason is because our bodies are so much more powerful than anything you can take. So you see here in the bottom, this is called an antioxidant hierarchy. And what this shows you is that supplements like vitamin C and E, they're good for you, but they're not as powerful as the ones our bodies make. So SOD, superoxide dismutase, catalase, and glutathione peroxidase, those are the three antioxidants that our body's own pharmacy makes. And as you see, the higher you go up on this antioxidant hierarchy, the more powerful these antioxidants are. They're more protective. The ones on the bottom are the ones you take, exogenous from the outside. The ones on the top are the endogenous ones from the inside. And those are even boost new cells, not just stimulate the existing cells, but boost the old, brand new cellular production, right? Now, this is great by itself, but we here with LifeVantage, our Protandim NRF2 Synergizer does a couple of other really amazing things. It boosts your body's production of glutathione peroxidase by 300%. This is so important because glutathione is called the master antioxidant. It not only is powerful by itself, but it helps all those other antioxidants you see on this hierarchy be more powerful as well. Our product boosts catalase production by 54%, and it boosts SOD, superoxide dismutase, by 30%. So remember earlier I told you one SOD molecule can get rid of a million free radicals. We just boosted that production of that by 30%. So that's the second reason that what you take isn't as powerful. Now, the third reason is because our body produces 130 sextillion free radicals. That's what's floating around inside our bodies. So we need a lot of antioxidant power. And so to do that, you'd have to eat 11 pounds of blueberries and 375 oranges, over 100 vitamin C tablets, over 100 cups of broccoli, all of that to equal one NRF2 activator. So you can activate your genes and ask yourself, would you rather take it, all of those things on the left, or would you rather that your genes turn on to have your body make those antioxidants? And obviously the answer is we want our body to make them, right? Now, let's talk about some peer-reviewed clinical studies. So again, this is important. When we put an expert witness on the stand, we ask him, have you done any testing? Did you write those up in a research paper? And then this is really important. Did you get that paper published in a peer-reviewed journal? So this is really important because a lot of companies, supplement companies especially, will say, we did a study, and they put it up on their website and they make you believe that it's a legitimate study. The only way you can be certain that a study is valid, both from a reliability standpoint, that it wasn't biased, is if it was peer-reviewed. So what this means is a scientist, he conducts a study and then he writes up his research paper and he then sends it to all of these various journals. Could be the Journal of the American Medical Association, Cell, Circulation, could be the British Medical Journal, thousands of journals around the world. And in those journals, they sit with editorial boards of scientists, researchers, and doctors who are experts in that particular topic. Those scientists review the original study. They decide if it's biased. Was the hypothesis accurate? Were the methods they used accurate? Was the math accurate and how they calculated things? And ultimately, were the conclusions supported by the findings in the study? And then, and only then, will it get published in a peer-reviewed journal. Only about 10% of research studies submitted to these peer-reviewed journals get published. So it's a really, really big deal when there's a peer-reviewed journal, and almost no supplements will have studies to start with, and even less of them will have peer-reviewed studies. So I challenge you, when you go into your GNC or your pharmacy, or even if you're going into a feed store, if you have horses or dogs, pick up the supplement that you feed and Google it on this place we're going to talk about and see if you can find that supplement having any peer-reviewed studies. So our product here, Protandim, actually has over 24 peer-reviewed studies, 7 patents in the United States alone, over a dozen around the world. That's why you know you can trust the results that this company does. We aren't required to do those studies, but we did. And here's what's powerful. We didn't do them. these are the places that conducted that research. Over on the right, you see Johns Hopkins. They were involved in the study from the National Institute of Aging. Texas Tech did a study about Duchenne's muscular dystrophy. Duke University right now is studying ALS or Lou Gehrig's disease and the impact of protandim. You see down here Virginia Commonwealth and Ohio State. They did really powerful studies about the impact of oxidative stress and cardiovascular disease and inflammation. And that study was published by the American Heart Association's journal called Circulation. That goes out to all the cardiologists all around the world. There's another study at Louisiana State University where they studied skin cancer or melanoma, and they found that protandim decreased both the incidence of skin cancer by over 30% and the multiplicity, or how much it duplicates, by 57%. Mayo Clinic has a study about ovarian cancer and multiple myeloma. The list goes on, and it's why I'm so proud to be associated with this company, because you can go look at peer-reviewed journals and hear about a lot of our studies. Now, normally we talk about a lot of those. We're only going to mention a few of them tonight because we're going to focus a lot on these studies related to autism and ADHD and other neurodegenerative disorders. But where should you go to find these studies? You can go to this U.S. government's website, and the Library of Congress has a website called pubmed.gov. And this website is where you're going to find peer-reviewed studies. So you're not going to find studies on here unless they have been published in a peer-reviewed journal. Now, we're going to look at some of those tonight. I want to emphasize to everybody, our products that we're going to talk about tonight, they don't treat, cure, mitigate, prevent any of the diseases we're going to discuss. That's what a pharmaceutical drug does. That's what happens when you get FDA approval. Supplements, all natural supplements, they're not granted FDA approval. They're not required to have studies submitted to the FDA. But what our products do is they will help decrease oxidative stress. They'll help you boost your mitochondrial production, decrease inflammation, help you detoxify your bodies, and that in turn helps your body do its best job of healing itself. Now, these are a bunch of the diseases that you can go to PubMed and Google with oxidative stress or inflammation, whether it's eye disease, respiratory diseases — that was a study about inflammation — cancer, heavy metal toxicity — we're going to talk a little bit about that tonight — all sorts of arthritis, osteoarthritis, rheumatoid arthritis. Here's a clue: anything that ends in itis, I-T-I-S, that's the medical term for inflammation, so you know that that could be impacted by nerve 2 activation. If things that happen in your intestines, inflammatory bowel disease, colic, ulcers — over on the left, diabetes, Cushing's, Graves, a lot of other disorders related to the metabolic system, our skin, acne, wrinkles, eczema, psoriasis — up on the left, huge impact on kidney disease, liver disease, fatty liver disease. We heard about cardiovascular disease with the American Heart Association. But tonight we're going to focus on neurodegenerative diseases. And you see the big, huge impact on neurodegenerative diseases from both oxidative stress, inflammation, and mitochondrial dysfunction, as well as toxins that you're going to hear about. So tonight we have an impact on everything, you know, Parkinson's, Huntington's, Alzheimer's, ALS, MS, powerful results in an MS, dementia, bipolar disorder, traumatic brain injuries, concussions. But tonight the focus is going to be on autism and ADHD, and we'll get to those in just a second. As we get started, though, this is one of the first studies that I read, and it kind of blew me away, because this all sounded too good to be true to me. How do you turn on your genes? Really, does it work that it helps with so many different disorders? And this study's out of Washington State in 2015, and they talk about those 500 survival genes. This is a generic study. We had nothing to do with this study at all. And they talk about how NRF2 helps with detoxification, the antioxidant effect, major anti-inflammatory changes, and boosting mitochondrial function, the same thing we've been talking about all night. And then you see these diseases that it talks about impacting, if you can impact all of those different processes. And there's a quote from this study that we love. It says, NRF2, it may well become the most extraordinary therapeutic and preventative breakthrough in the history of medicine. Let that sink in. In the history of medicine, that's one of the reasons we are so proud to be one of the pioneers in this field of NRF2 activation. Now, you can go to PubMed and you can Google protandim. And when you do that, you're going to find 24 peer-reviewed studies. This is one of the 24 out of the University of Montreal up in Quebec. So all of our Canadians on the call tonight, you see here that protandim was studied in the context of osteoarthritis, and they found that it decreases free radical production, that it increases that internal pharmacy to boost your antioxidant production internally. It helps with your mitochondrial metabolism, and it preserves cartilage and abolishes a number of factors, completely eliminates a number of factors known to be associated with osteoarthritis. We're not going to go through the rest of the studies tonight. You can go to PubMed yourself. We'll show you how we can link you to that site later on as well. But there's one study I want to focus on tonight about our product Protandim. And this was a study that was funded by a drug company. This was the drug company that called Biogen. They make an MS drug called Tecfidera. This is a drug that is now FDA approved for treating MS. And this drug is a Nrf2 activator, just like our product Protandim. SFN in this study was called sulforaphane that comes from broccoli. And so they studied Protandim, and here's what this scientist found over in the Netherlands back in 2011, that Protandim strongly induces Nrf2 antioxidant production, just like our study said in 2006, and that Protandim was the most potent inducer of all the things they're studying, and therefore might be the most suited as therapeutic strategy. Now, as you can imagine, the drug company didn't want this published. So luckily, this was a little abstract discussed at a paper at a conference of a whole bunch of MS researchers and doctors and scientists back in 2011. And we have a copy of this that was the little paragraph that was published in the MS journal. But this is what they found. They found that Protandim, you can see here, outperformed Tecfidera down on the bottom, outperformed sulforaphane and broccoli, and outperformed this toxic drug as well. And you can hear my Malamute in the background. Sorry about that, folks. So we are going to talk tonight about the impact of Protandim as well on the aging process, because if we can decrease our oxidative stress, if we can boost our mitochondrial production, we can slow down the aging process. And this has been all the talk in the press, right? You want to extend your lifespan. How do you live to be 100? How do you live to be healthy to 100? And so our study in 2006 was the first one that came out. And yes, we studied it in humans. So what you can see here is we studied 29 humans and we activated them with Protandim Nrf2. You can see their age 20 through 78. That's along the bottom arm of this graph. And on the left side is their oxidative stress levels. So before Protandim, their T-bar levels, you can see, started out just around 1 and 1.5, all the way up to almost to 4, right? Now, after Protandim Nrf2 activation, you see everybody's levels dropped. This was that 40% decrease in 30 days. But here's what's even more impressive, that after 30 days, the researchers couldn't distinguish the blood and the oxidative stress levels of a 20-year-old from that of a 78-year-old. You do that every day over the rest of your life, and you are going to have a significant impact on lifespan. And in fact, that's what happened. The U.S. government, I mentioned before, the National Institute of Aging, 10 years after our first study was published, they spent several years studying Protandim, in addition to a lot of other products, including things like metformin, which diabetics take, to see if they extended life. And this is when they found that our product extended life by 7%. Now, that's a big overview of our Nrf2 activator. We're going to briefly talk about our Nrf1 activator that came out in 2016. It stimulates mitochondria. So a lot of people may not know what mitochondria is, what they are. You can see here these worm-like structures in the cell. Those are our body's mitochondria. And they are energy supplies for our cells. They're the engines that create 95% of our body's energy. And it's so important to have healthy mitochondria. We not only want big, robust, healthy mitochondria, but we want a lot of them. Because what happens is when your mitochondria die, if all of them die, you die. We have to have healthy mitochondria to have a healthy body. Now, what we know is if you have healthy mitochondria, your body runs like a finely tuned sports car. If you don't, it's kind of like a beat up old jalopy with a defective engine, right? So let's go back to PubMed. Let's look at the science again. And what you see here is Nrf1. There's only about 1,000 studies about Nrf1, and there's over almost 12,000 about Nrf2. So Nrf1 really is kind of cutting edge science. And as you see here, this study says Nrf2, it's a new strategic avenue to prevent and treat cancer, and importantly for what we're talking about tonight, neurodegenerative diseases. But what I love is this study was published in 2018 when they're saying it's this new science. Our Nrf2 activator was released in 2016. So just like we were a pioneer with Nrf2 activation, our Nrf1 activator was released in 2016, and we too are a pioneer in this field as well. So what is our Nrf1 activator? You see it here. It helps with your mitochondrial function. It enhances your existing mitochondria pumps them up and it boosts your body's production of new mitochondria, helps you with sleep. I'm actually getting phenomenal REM sleep, dreaming, sleeping much longer through the night, not waking up in the middle of the night. And then importantly, mitochondria are significantly important for both cardiovascular health and your neurological health, because your heart can have up to 5,000 mitochondria in the cells, and your brain, your neurological system, even though it's only 2% of your body's weight, it takes up to 20% of your body's mitochondrial energy. So that's why when you have just minor impacts on your body's mitochondria, you can have massive impacts on your cardiovascular system as well as your neurological system. So what's in our NRF1 activator? You see on the left, alpha-lipoic acid, CoQ10, and grape extract or resveratrol. A lot of your cardiologists may have you taking those supplements. Quercetin, which I am in love with for all of the main massive things it does. It's kind of new to me. And then acetyl-L-carnitine. Personal trainers sometimes have their clients take this before a workout at the gym. Why? Because it helps boost your ATP or your body's energy so you can get a better workout in. Now, a lot of people are like, Michelle, this gets so confusing. This is science. How do I make this simple? Think about it like this, like it's a fireplace. So when you want to build a fire, you put big healthy logs on the fire, big thick logs, and you put a lot of them on. Think of that like your mitochondria in your cells. So if you want a big fire, lots of logs. If you want healthy cells, lots of mitochondria and big healthy mitochondria. But we know as we burn a fire in the fireplace, we produce waste product. That's the soot at the bottom of the fireplace. That's very similar to the free radicals that you build up in your body, in your cells, when you utilize oxygen. And so if you don't clean the soot out of the fireplace, your cell doesn't, your fire doesn't burn well. If you don't clean the free radicals out of your cell doesn't function as well. So just like a fireplace, we want more logs on the fire, we want bigger logs on the fire, and we want to clean the waste product or the soot out of the fireplace. That's how NRF2 and NRF1 work together to boost boost your mitochondrial production and to decrease your body's oxidative stress. Now, here's what we know about NRF1, is that it helps the aging process as well. So you see here, these are DNA. This is your DNA on a chromosome. We know we've got 23 chromosomes, right? And here at the end, there's these little end caps. They're like the end caps on a shoelace. They protect your DNA. And as we age, those end caps or telomeres, they get shorter. And what NRF1 does is it helps protect your end caps or your telomeres to protect your body's DNA. And that's why we're seeing it improve and extend our aging, right? Now, let's now talk about what a lot of you came to hear about tonight, which is our neurological studies related to NRF1, NRF2, and some of the other things about autism and ADHD. So I'm going to take you back to PubMed again. So go to PubMed and Google oxidative stress and autism. And you're going to see, you know, here you can Google and just get almost 500 studies. These are, again, the peer-reviewed studies. About 100 about oxidative stress and ADHD. So this is new emerging science. That may be why a lot of you that are parents or grandparents, or maybe if you have autism or ADHD yourself, you haven't heard about this, is because it's kind of cutting edge. You can see if you Google oxidative stress in other neurodegenerative diseases or neurons, you're going to see how many studies are peer-reviewed studies about those. But even pesticides, because we know that pesticides, herbicides, fungicides, they're having a big impact on kiddos with autism and oxidative and ADHD. You'll hear about that tonight. But you can also Google antioxidants or inflammation in the brain. Look at how many studies are related to inflammatory process in your brain. And yet, right now, they're just learning that inflammation is impacting autism as well. So I encourage you to go there and look for yourself, read these articles yourself. A lot of them are very deep, complicated scientific studies, but there's usually a summary at the beginning that's the abstract that can give you a little bit of an overview of what these studies show. Now, when you go to PubMed, you'll find studies like this. And this was a study out that talks about mitochondrial dysfunction. And as you can see, the things in the dark blue are the things that are significantly impacted by defective mitochondria. And what we know is if you have healthy mitochondria, you have healthy neurons in your neurological system. And what they're finding in these new science is there's overwhelming evidence. That's the quote from one of these studies, that impaired mitochondria isn't just linked to neurodegenerative diseases, but in many cases, it's causing neurodegenerative diseases like autism and ADHD. And that they believe, these studies talk about therapies that target mitochondria, and that they hold great promise in helping out with neurodegenerative diseases. This is a study out of Stanford University, one of the best med schools in the whole entire world. They're talking about the relationship between oxidative stress and neurodegenerative diseases. You see the diseases they reference up at the top, including ADHD and autism. And you can see that they say that brain, it's particularly susceptible and especially vulnerable to oxidative stress. And that goes back to what I mentioned before, that our brain uses 20% of our body's oxygen and 20% of our body's mitochondrial energy. So that's why we want to control oxidative stress and mitochondria. Now, let's talk about autism and some of those studies you can find on PubMed. So this is April. It's obviously Autism Awareness Month. So that's one of the reasons we wanted to bring attention to this today. Here's several different studies you can see about autism and oxidative stress. We know that SOD, catalase, and glutathione peroxidase levels are decreased in people with autism. What do we know about protandem nerve 2? That it increased SOD by 30%, catalase by 54%, and glutathione peroxidase by 300%. We know that glutathione, that master antioxidant, that it's neuroprotective. It helps protect our bodies against that oxidative stress in autism and other spectrum disorders, right? And again, these studies say decreasing oxidative stress might be a potential treatment for people with any disorders on the spectrum. We also know that mitochondrial dysfunction is related to autism. Here's a study out of Columbia University in 2013. Again, another one of the best medical schools in the entire country and the entire world. They have a follow-up study in 2017 talking about mitochondria. And these studies repeat what we've talked about. Mitochondrial damage and dysfunction, they're implicated in autism. And with autism, they don't know yet whether it's mitochondrial dysfunction is causing autism or if it's the effect of other damage that occurs. But ultimately, they know that mitochondria is damaged in people that have autism. What I found really curious, and they don't really know the reason why yet, is that mitochondrial changes are more evident in children with autism and spectrum disorders than adults. So don't know the reason yet. Could it be because our body's endogenous antioxidant system and pharmacy go to work over our lifespan helping us? We don't know. We don't know the answer, but an interesting finding that I wasn't expecting to see when I read these studies. Now there's another thing that's linked to autism. You guys may have heard of Roundup or these pesticides, fungicides, insecticides, right? They're spraying on weeds, they're spraying it on our corn and soy crops. And wow, I found this study that blew my mind. You can go read the study and it correlates these insecticides that they're using on our crops. And almost without exception, any disease you can think of, whether it's cancer or immune disorders, fibromyalgia, all sorts of diseases, they're on the increase, and those increases correlate with the increase in the use of insecticides. You can see here the correlation with autism is actually the most, that is almost completely aligned. So that, for me, caused me to sit back and take notice. So shocked me. I actually have a friend who told me today that her city regularly sprays, and this might impact some of you up in the Toronto area, regularly sprays with an insecticide to get rid of silkworms. Those insecticides, they're finding a correlation with autism, ADHD, and a whole lot of other disorders. Here's a study that just came out, just in March of 2019. That's how new the science is. This is out of Southern California. They actually went to the Central Valley area where they produce a lot of crops. That's a big farming community. And they studied moms who had been within 2,000 meters of this crop dusting, right, with insecticides and herbicides. And then they studied moms from the Central Valley who were further away than 2,000 meters. And the study was conducted again by Stanford University and UCLA, two phenomenal med schools. It was published in the British Medical Journal. So widely, widely respected journal all around the world. And what they found is that these insecticides and fungicides, that they are exponentially implicated in spectrum disorders. And that the risk of any of the spectrum disorders, it increases with herbicide and pesticide exposures. And this was just ambient exposure. This was the exposure in the air. This wasn't in the soil. This wasn't that you were eating. There's also other studies you can find, fungicides, insecticides, herbicides in the wine you drink, in the cereal that you feed your children. That's why it's so important to eat organic. And you can see here the exposure, just from the ambient exposure, not ingesting it, was 16 times increase in autism and other spectrum disorders. So that's one of the reasons that we are finding correlations here. And this is another correlation with heavy metals like lead and manganese. And again, a positive correlation between the severity of spectrum disorders and the higher levels of heavy metal exposure and lower levels of glutathione. Now, there are some studies that say they can't find the link. This is kind of a new emerging area. But for me, when I found the study from the U.S. National Institute of Health, again, saying that they found a link between autism and heavy metals that they studied inside the baby teeth, that for them, for me, was very powerful, because it doesn't get much more powerful than a study published by the U.S. National Institute of Health. Now, the reason I mentioned is I want to go back to that study we mentioned about Washington State University. We talked about it at the beginning. That study also talked about the detoxification that happens with Nrf2 activation. There's 25 different genes in our body that impact detoxification. We know that Nrf2 stimulates five of those, all 25 of those, but it also stimulates five different genes that help boost our glutathione production, which again, associated with autism and all the other spectrum disorders. We know that Nrf2 stimulates genes related to chelation. That's the detoxification process, the transport, getting those dangerous chemicals out of our body and dangerous metals and excreting them. So those, again, toxic metals like lead, cadmium, mercury. As an aside, I just watched a study last night about the high levels of autism and spectrum disorders in communities like Flint, Michigan, and in low-income communities where they still have lead paint on the building where these low-income children are being raised. And what we know from these studies is that Nrf2, it has a substantial role in producing our body's resistance to toxic metal exposure. And this is a quote from that Washington State study: to the hundreds of millions of people around the world who are exposed daily to substantial levels of toxicants, detoxification may be the most important Nrf2 cytoprotective mechanism, meaning the most important thing Nrf2 does for your cells, and that Nrf2, it's likely to be of great importance in health promotion, particularly in those regularly exposed to toxic chemicals. That's one of the reasons we are so excited about Nrf2 activation. So that's how it impacts autism. Let's talk about ADD and ADHD as well. So again, we're seeing the same pattern: oxidative stress, remarkably low levels of SOD or superoxide dismutase in adults with ADHD, significantly lower levels of glutathione peroxidase in kids and teens with ADHD. And what we know is that science is now starting to recognize that maybe some of these natural compounds that Chinese and Asian medicine has been using for years, maybe there's something to it, and we better look at these because there's fewer side effects. One of the things that scared me, because my foster son was put on some of these drugs, is that ADHD drugs, some of them are known, like Ritalin, right? They're known to cause more oxidative stress, neuroinflammation, neurodegeneration, or damage in your neurological system. And here's what's powerful too: dopamine neuron loss. So dopamine is your happy neurotransmitter. So you may be helping your child regulate at 6 or 16, but what are you doing to his happiness at 26, 36, maybe 66, right? So if there's a way that we can either use these in conjunction with or separate from, we want to certainly see if we can help our bodies turn on its own pharmacy to help heal itself. Now, wow, we want to talk to you about testimonials. So again, witnesses on the stand. I don't just want to hear from the expert witness. I want to hear about people who witnessed an accident, right? And the same thing applies here. What are the moms and grandparents and people with ADHD and autism saying about Nrf2 activation? We know that they are using our Nrf1 and Nrf2 activator, but they're using a couple of other products as well. We have a Nrf2 activated energy drink. Some of them are using pre and probiotics, and some of them are using omegas, and we'll talk about all those as well. This is a video. I'm not going to play it tonight. It's about 20 minutes long. I want to be respectful of your time. But all of these are parents who have children with either ADHD or autism. The two on the top have kids that are on the spectrum. The two on the bottom, ADHD. And what I love about this is, you know, this mom over on the right on the bottom, she tried all sorts of pharmaceutical drugs. She didn't believe in holistic treatment. The mom on the top left didn't want to use pharmaceutical drugs. She actually loved holistic treatments, but didn't have any results until she tried Protandim, even though she had been seeing lots of naturopaths. And she talks about all of these different specialists telling her, my toolbox is empty. I don't know what to tell you to do to help your kiddos. And these parents talk about rages. They talk about hours and hours of rages about impulsivity, hyperactivity. The mom on the bottom right talks about her child that was threatening to kill himself as well. So I can relate to that. And these testimonials, they moved me. So we wanted to give you just some excerpts of a couple people. This is a mom who shared a testimonial with us. You can get whoever invited you to this webinar to add you to a testimonial page to read some of these. They were on NRF1, NRF2, and Axia, weren't using a pre or probiotic or omegas. And prior to that, their child had no neurological developmental improvement. And this quote broke my heart because she said, "I was just an arm that got him objects." And then she activated him with NRF2 and NRF1. And now he can draw faces. And this is a picture of his drawing. He no longer has that head bashing and hyperactivity. His eye contact is better. He sleeps through the night. In fact, the African-American father on the prior slide, he said within a couple of days, his son was sleeping through the whole night. And that had never happened before. This mom's talking about he can bend his knees to jump where he couldn't do that before. He pretends to ride a horse. He's mimicking things. He plays with family members, family and nursery staff. He gives hugs and kisses. So for a mom whose child has never given them a hug and a kiss, imagine this impact. And the child's calm and happy, right? This mom says, "Now I have a completely different child," not because we treat, cure, prevent, or mitigate any of those diseases. All we do is help the body, empower the body to go back and optimize its own health. That's why I love this. We have another mom who had a daughter with kind of mildly on the spectrum, Asperger's. You know, she was diagnosed at 22 months. They tried all sorts of supplements. She would have meltdowns several times a day, a couple of hours at a time, couldn't cope with strangers and changes, right? Her anxiety decreased after NRF2 activation. She's more social, more adaptable, attentive, and calm. Meltdowns decreased tremendously. And I love this because a lot of moms are seeing grades in school that changed. I have a friend whose child has sensory processing disorder, was failing. Brilliant, brilliant child, but was failing at the end of the first semester this fall. And now the report card is so much better. They're getting great calls that instead of calls in the middle of the day to come pick up their child, instead of their child getting kicked out of school like my foster son was in first grade, he got suspended repeatedly. He got completely kicked out of school. He had the police called on him from school. Having a child go from something like that to a child whose grades increase, and in this particular case, the child's not even in special ed classes anymore, no longer working within that IEP. This is why we're so proud to be associated with it. And, you know, we're getting towards the end here, but a lot of you may have been invited to this webinar with this picture. And this is a picture and a quote from a mom whose daughter said, "I want popcorn." She was 20 years old, nonverbal, self-harming. She was wearing a helmet most of the time and sometimes even in restraints. And they were saying, either you have to institutionalize your daughter or we're going to take custody of her at the state. And so she tried NRF2 activation. And after a few weeks of being on NRF2 activation, her daughter actually said, "I want popcorn." So for me, that was so profound because she understood this whole time. She understood language. She knew what people were telling her, but she couldn't find the words to talk about what it is that she wanted. That's a study, a testimony that comes from this physician right here. And all of the people you see on this slide are people who are doctors or in the medical profession here with our company. We have about 1,200 medical professionals who not only use our products, but are distributors as well. The "I want popcorn" testimonials from this woman here, Dr. Nancy Bryan. She is a pharmacist. She herself is a breast cancer survivor and a melanoma survivor. And she fell in love with the company because of that LSU study about melanoma. But then she has a friend named Arlene who has two of her five children who are on the spectrum. And her 20-year-old daughter was the most severe, and she is the one, she was on the phone with her actually when she said, "I want popcorn." She tells this testimony about how it changed the family's life. The daughter's back in school, the family can take vacations again. There's another doctor I wanna mention to you in the context of autism and ADHD. It's this doctor here, Dr. Brett Brimhall. He had been treating a child for over a year, specialized in treating children with autism and children on the spectrum. He's actually here in Arizona where I'm located. And that child came in 1 week and it was like a light switch was switched on. And that light switch was a Nutrigenomics switch because all of a sudden he saw a massive improvement. So we said to the mom, what's going on? What happened? What changed? And she said, well, I didn't want to tell you. I didn't tell his teachers. I didn't tell his counselors, but I'm trying an all-natural herbal supplement called the Nrf2 activator. And at the time, there was only a Nrf2 activator. There wasn't Axio or Nrf1. As that has gone on, as we have developed Nrf1 and Axio, she's put him on those as well as our omegas and our probiotics, and has continuing to see improvement in him. He's playing sports. He's in, he's mainstreamed, right? That is the testimony. And this doctor, he had never been involved with direct sales like this company. He was a skeptic. Took him a year of seeing the results get better and better and better, and other patients responding, when he finally decided, I have to be part of spreading the news about how decreasing your oxidative stress, decreasing your inflammation, and boosting your mitochondrial production, how that can help with kiddos with ADHD and autism. So one of the products that he loves, that all of us love, I personally love it, is Axio. It's a Nrf2 activated energy drink, no sugar in it, only 15 calories, GMO, non-GMO, vegan, and it comes in five different amazing flavors. These are the different ingredients in our Nrf2 activator. We have both caffeinated and decaffeinated. For me, you can see them here, magnesium, L-theanine, B vitamins. You're going to see correlations in clinical studies about that. But I have come to fall in love with pine bark extract and quercetin, and you're going to see why that's having such a massive impact. So here again, more peer-reviewed studies from PubMed about the impact of pine bark in kiddos with ADHD. It causes a statistically significant increase in your body's total antioxidant status in kiddos with ADHD. It stimulates SOD and glutathione. And then behaviorally, this is what I love, there's a significant reduction in hyperactivity, improved attention, concentration, visual motor coordination in children with ADHD. And 1 month after they stopped pine bark extract, there's a relapse in the symptoms. So it seems to be something that the body says, I need on a continuing basis, right? Pine bark extract, one of the main ingredients in our Axio energy drink. We also know that there's a few other things in Axio. You see here, vitamin B12 is three times lower in people on the spectrum, that we know from other studies, glutathione deficiency in people on the spectrum. L-theanine helps boys with ADHD sleep through the night. That's in our Axio. And we also know that low magnesium is associated with ADHD, but not just with neurodegenerative disorders and ADHD. A lot of people are deficient in magnesium. So make sure when you were with your doctor and they pull a blood panel that you check your magnesium levels and your vitamin B levels as well. Now, here's again more clinical proof. So what is this? This is an expert witness. He's a PhD in psychology who's doing some brain mapping before and after his patients have tried Nrf2, Nrf1, and Axio. And so here's what you see on the left-hand side before the child was Nrf2 activated. On the right-hand side, just a couple of weeks later, the brain mapping after he was Nrf2 activated. Here's another example of that same child with ADD. On the left, you can see the brain and all of the different messages that are going through the brain. You don't have to be a scientist to see that there's a different one on the right. And again, whoever invited you to the webinar can get you that interview if you want to hear about that. But I also love that Axio works for everybody, whether you're a college student just trying to have better focus, whether you're working on a big project or a presentation at work, whether you're an athlete getting ready for a game. It helps with brain fog and focus, helps boost your energy. And what you see here is a child who doesn't have autism or ADHD. This child is Dr. Brett Brimhall's nephew. And before on the left is his spelling before he was Nrf2 activated, on the right after he was Nrf2 activated. I love documentary evidence, physical evidence, clinical studies, testimonial evidence. You're seeing that over and over and over here. Every kind of evidence that I would ask a witness on the stand if they have, this is the kind of evidence that I found looking into our products. Now, the last thing, couple things we're going to talk about are omegas and probiotics. So a couple weeks ago, actually 2 months ago, I went to a presentation at Mayo Clinic. I have some family members struggling with cancer right now. And they were talking about what supplements you shouldn't use when you have cancer. And one of the oncologists got up and said, listen, everybody in this room, whether you're a cancer patient, a cancer survivor, or somebody that's never had cancer, everybody needs to be taking an omega, because unless you're a walrus, you are not getting enough omega-3s in your diet. And that just stuck with me, because like, what a profound statement. Every single human being needs to supplement with omegas, but we know with kiddos with ADHD and autism, it's even more important, and you'll hear in a second why. We have an omega here. I love it for several reasons. It has omega-3s in it. It's DHA dominant, which is more important for neurological and neurodegenerative disorders. EPA-dominant omegas are great for cardiovascular disease. We also have omega-7s in our product. We have no omega-6s. We get plenty of omega-6s in our diet. You don't want to have an omega product that has omega-6s in it. But what I love about our product are two things. First of all, it tastes good. So you don't have burps. You don't have that awful burp because it has lemon oil and lime oil in it. So you don't really taste the fish oil. I've actually bitten into it and you don't taste it. But most importantly, you can trace our bottle. You can trace our omegas from the boat to the bottle. So just like beer goes stale, just like fish goes stale, you wouldn't want to have fish that's 6 months old or 6 years old. So you don't want to be buying a bottle of omega-3s that has 1,000 tablets in it. You don't want it to be a clear bottle because omega-3s are impacted by oxidation. So you want a dark bottle. You want to prevent it from having its oxidation, right? And that's what you can do with our bottle. And you can trace it back to the exact boat that it came from. You don't want to take omegas that are old and rancid. Fish goes old and rancid, it's bad for you. Omega-3s get rancid and they are harmful to your body instead of helpful. So very important to make sure your fish oils are fresh. Whether you use ours or somebody else's, you definitely want to get them on a monthly basis and not a massive yearly dosage. But I want to show you this study because for me, with somebody that struggles with ADD, I did not realize how important omegas were for my diet. And what you can see on the left is the levels of EPA in gray for what they call a typically developing child and the levels of DHA in blue. And here is a child with ADHD, here's a child with autism, and not a child, these are a bunch of children that they studied. And what they found is that there's a little bit of a decrease in your child's levels of EPA, but there is a significant decrease in your levels of DHA for both kiddos with ADHD and autism. So make sure you ask your pediatrician to run a blood panel on your kid or your own physician to run your own blood panel and check your omega-3 levels. What are your DHA and EPA levels so you know how to supplement? But just as important, what are your omega-6 levels and what's that ratio? Because what we know is that most children have about 40% of omega-3s compared to that 100% of omega-6s. But again, with kids with ADHD and autism, the levels decrease 27% of the level of omega-3s compared to 6s, and in ADHD, 17%. Now, they don't know why this is, but they know that they are significantly more deficient than typically developing children. Many researchers will tell you you should have a 1-to-1 ratio. I know for myself, I actually look for a 2-to-1 ratio, having more omega-3s than omega-6s. That's because all of our processed food have omega-6s in them already. And so it's even more important if you regularly eat fast food, junk food, anything that's a processed food, you need even more omega-3s because some humans here in the United States and Canada, some people have 10-to-1 or 20-to-1 ratios of omega-6s, and we need to flip that, right? So this is actually another, back to PubMed, back to those peer-reviewed studies about the impact on your gut-brain axis and your microbiome, the good bacteria in your gut, and how it impacts autism and ADHD. So what you see here is a picture of your microbiome, and this is where most, this is your stomach, and this is where most probiotics get eaten up. And as you can see here, there's 1,000 species of good bacteria down here in your intestines, but if your probiotic gets eaten up here in your stomach, it's never going to get those healthy bacteria down where they need to go, right? And so we have a probiotic that we love. It has a protection around it called BioTract that helps it go past those stomach acids. So most probiotics, you may only absorb 4% of what you take, even if you're spending a lot for it and you're refrigerating it, and maybe you're paying $100 a bottle, you're only going to get about 4% of those healthy bacteria, good gut bacteria. Here with BioTract, you get 60% that makes it down into your gut. Now, what I will caution you about is make sure your physician or your pediatrician or developmental pediatrician runs your child's microbiome, checks their bacteria levels, because children with ADD and ADHD and autism, they can have differing levels and they may need a different type of probiotic. It may be that ours works great. It may be that you need one that doesn't have lactobacillus in it. You need to make sure you're supplementing your child with the healthy bacteria that he needs. So again, consult with your physician to run those specifics, right? So here we have a lot of people that use our all five of our products. You see NRF1, NRF2, our physique, our probiotic, our omegas, and then obviously our Axio. Now, The last few slides I'm just going to talk to you about, because some of you have never heard of our company, and I just want to give you a little bit of history about it so that you know that you can trust it, in addition to all of the evidence that we just showed you. So our company started back in 2003 as a biotech company. It wasn't a direct sales company. It was founded by a scientist, several scientists, one of whom actually discovered that sod antioxidant in our bodies back when he was a grad student at Duke University. And then in 2005, we were actually featured on ABC Primetime, that gotcha journalism show. And gotcha journalism shows, they don't usually try to prove a product works. They're trying to prove the opposite, right? But our product performed. That journalist that you see here, John Quinones, he participated in our study, and his oxidative stress levels went down by 46% in just 2 weeks. So he even outperformed our average in our study. And after that was on ABC News, that this could possibly turn back the hands of time, all sorts of news shows featured us, PBS's show called Healing Quest. You see then our sales skyrocketed. We were being sold over the counter in places like Whole Foods and GNC, right? And what we found is we were selling about half a bottle per store per month. But this ABC Primetime, it spiked our sales, and our revenue went up from $2 million to $7 million. But we were run by a bunch of scientists, not salesmen. We didn't have the infrastructure. It took almost a year to fill $5 million worth of orders. They were back ordered. Customers weren't happy. And our sales started plummeting again. And by 2009, they'd gone back down to $2 million. And so our board of directors said, how is this possible? We have this product that is potentially impacting lifespan. We have this product that's helping reduce oxidative stress, and our sales are only $2 million. We're only moving half a bottle. What do we need to do? And business consultants told them you need to move it to direct sales because you need to have somebody tell the story, just like we did tonight, right? You have to tell the story because NRF2 was sitting on the shelf next to vitamin C and people didn't know what NRF2 was. And that's why it wasn't moving. So they moved to direct sales. Within 2 years, by 2012, we were over $100 million in sales from $2 million. And then for the last 5 years, we've been hovering right about or above $200 million in sales. You can check us out. I loved this. Again, more validation. We are a publicly traded company. You can check us on the NASDAQ, the same place that Apple and Microsoft are, and Google. Our stock ticker is LFVN. It's a really big deal for a company to be on the NASDAQ. We have to be transparent. You can see our financial statements. We can't hide things from the Securities and Exchange Commission. So one more big check mark in the credibility column. Also wanted to mention to you, we talked about being pioneers. You can see these are the studies on PubMed about NRF2. The blue line is the number of studies every year. The red line is the number of cumulative studies. And you can see we started in 2003. There was almost nobody else in this field when we got started. Our 2006, our first study, 2009, one of our patents talking about C-reactive protein. 2015 is when that Washington State study comes out, when there's already 8,000 studies about NRF2 activation, when they say it's the greatest therapeutic and preventative breakthrough in the history of medicine. And then now in 2018, we know that there's about 12,000 studies about NRF2 activation. And compare that to the studies about inflammation and oxidative stress on PubMed. Doctors and researchers and scientists have known this is an issue for a long time. That's why there's over half a million study, right? Half a million studies about inflammation. You're going to see this number continuing to increase. And that's why we're so proud that we were one of the pioneers in this field. And then finally, a lot of people say, is this direct sales? Is it one of those things? And my response to you is yes, it's one of those things that millionaires and billionaires have invested in. So this down here came from our SEC filing. So this is what's called institutional investors or hedge funds. These are the guys that are millionaires and billionaires, kind of like the people on Shark Tank. So think about guys with Shark Tank money. And almost never will you see any hedge funds or Wall Street investing in a direct sales company. And you can see the evidence of that here. We didn't have any all the way through 2017. And then slowly, people are starting to pay attention. And then the last two quarters of 2018, you are going to see that these hedge funds, millionaires and billionaires, bought $30 million worth of our company stock. They did that because they know something. They're catching on to this NRF2 science. And I got the list up here at the top of some of the companies that are investing in us. BlackRock. BlackRock is the largest hedge fund in the world. They control $6 trillion worth of assets. they actually owned $3.5 million worth of our company stock. And then I want to talk to you about Renaissance Technologies because they used to be advisors for the Department of Defense breaking codes. Renaissance Technologies has returned over 30% average for their investors over the last 20 years. And here's a quote about who they are. They're not Wall Street guys. These are brilliant mathematicians, physicists, statisticians, and they go in and they predict what's going to happen. Renaissance Technology is the leader on Wall Street. When they invest, others invest because they have the most successful return on their investment of all of these institutional investors or hedge funds, and they own over $15 million worth of our stock. That's why you know this company is different. Millionaires and billionaires have invested their clients' money, those millionaires and billionaires who are their clients, and probably some of your 401k money could be one of the other pension funds that you have. If you're with BlackRock or Renaissance, they are invested in LifeVantage. So that's how you know that in addition to the evidence of the clinical studies, that you have this financial evidence too. So if you want to learn more about this, is the second to last slide. You can go to a website called Biohack and Activate. It has that ABC Primetime video if you haven't seen it. It also has links to some of those PubMed studies that you can click on. It'll take you right to PubMed so you don't have to find them yourselves. It has testimonials from some of those doctors you saw on the slides. And it even has testimonials about how this impacts the horse world and the dog world because all mammals are impacted by NRF1 and NRF2 activation. So we just close tonight by telling you thank you for joining us tonight here at LifeVantage. I am just blessed and privileged to be with this company because we are making such a difference in so many people's lives and in the lives of kiddos like my foster son and my friend's son with sensory processing disorder and my niece and nephew and other people that I love and care about. So we just want to ask you to get back to whomever invited you to this call tonight. Let them know whether you're interested in being a customer. If you want more information about our products, what we can do to get you on those testimonial pages to hear some of those testimonials from parents who have had their children's lives change. So get back to whomever invited you. And thank you again for joining me tonight. I'm very, very privileged and honored that you spent some time with us. And I hope you all have a really, really wonderful evening.